Well, power crews are busy tonight trying to keep the lights on this cold evening.
KMBC 9's Cliff Judy is live with what's going on. Cliff.
Kelly, you can see what this heavy, wet snow has done to trees around this area. Obviously, these two huge branches around me are victims of this heavy, wet snow. Now, I'm going to see if the snow can support my weight. If it can't, I'm going to go down all the way down to my knees in snow. But as you get out to the street, we're all right. You look across the street, and you've got neighbors out here that are having to shovel themselves out of their driveway. Now, this is part of an area that never lost power. They're lucky. We talked to KCP&L earlier this afternoon. They tell us that nearly 100,000 customers were without power, specifically about 97,400 at the height of this storm. At its worst, they have knocked that down now to less than 30,000 people without power, and they are hoping to get everybody back on the grid by sometime tomorrow. They have people working all the way through the night. Their workers are going to make sure that they can't get as many people as possible back on the grid through the night. Now, I asked one of the KCP&L workers, what is this compared to ice? And he said, we would rather have 2 feet of snow any day of the week instead of getting ice. And thankfully, that's what happened with this storm.
When you put ice and wind together, that you get 2002 ice storm, and that has a much bigger impact on our system than snow does. Now, this snow being wet along with the wind certainly had an impact on us.
Again, KCP&L says that it has less than 30,000 people without power right now. Just to give you an idea of how arbitrary this thing is, this block right here, they never lost power. But you go to the end of the street and all of those houses down there, they don't have any porch lights on. They are still waiting to get their power back. Back to you in the studio.